going to mention to people that they have the choice to not be recorded, like, or will they just see
how Zoom sends, like, the, like, they can click on Zoom whether they want to or not?
Yeah, okay. Mm-hmm.
Okay, I'm about to hit the live button. My video off. So I'm about to hit the live button, and in the document, in the WhatsApp, I'm going to paste the link on Facebook. So if you're sitting around and you're just listening and you have much to do and you go on social media, you can post the link onto the Facebook live video. Okay, so I'm going to hit the thing now. You won't hear from me except for over the WhatsApp chat. Is anybody not on the WhatsApp chat?
Oh, Daniel. Andy, do you have Daniel's number?
Daniel, if you can just type in your number in the chat here to directly to Rebecca.
And then I she'll
do that. Once we're live, are you just going to start adding people then, Rebecca, from the waiting room?
Sorry?
Once we're live, you'll start adding people.
Yeah.
Just tell me when I'm live.
Okay, I'm about to hit the button. So everybody look your best.
Hello, I think we're live. We are live. So yeah, welcome to the online rally. We're here today to demand that Lloyds of London rule out insuring the West Cumbria mine and also the Adani mega mine in Australia. People are just starting to arrive, so hello to the people who've just come in from the meeting room. We're also have gone live on social media, so if you're seeing this on the live stream either now or recorded in the future, welcome. This is going to go on for an hour and a half, and we're going to be hearing from speakers as well as taking action together. So people who've just arrived in the Zoom, if you wanted to introduce yourself in the chat, just say hello and who you are. I'm Andrew, by the way, from Coal Action Network. But yeah, please introduce yourself in the chat as you're arriving. We're going to get going relatively soon, but we're going to give it a little bit of time for other people to arrive. So yeah.
Andy, you're on mute.
Oh my God, sorry. I was just speaking on mute. That was very embarrassing. A great start. Hi everyone. Welcome to the rally today. We're doing a rally to demand that Lloyds of London rule out insuring the West Cumbrian coal mine and the Adani mega mine in Australia. So I'm Andrew from Coal Action Network and lovely to see you all. Yeah, we're gonna just have a few minutes to get other people a chance to get online. While you're waiting, if you wanna introduce yourself in the chat, say hello, where you're from, where you're dropping in from today, that would be lovely. For the people on the live stream, hello as well. If you're watching this now or in the future, this will go on for about an hour and a half, and we're going to be taking action together today, as well as hearing from speakers from Cumbria and Australia about the two coal mines that we're asking Lloyds of London to rule out. So yeah, we're going to be starting in a couple of minutes. So hello everyone, I see you all saying hi in the chat. Welcome, quite a few different places all over. Yeah, if you're just joining, we're just waiting for everybody to arrive before we get going. We had quite a lot of people who RSVP'd for this. Hopefully the bad weather, I don't know, maybe it's blue sky where you are, it's gonna mean that people join us, but if it's too nice, people may not want to join another Zoom. But it's going to be an exciting Zoom, so stay tuned. Yeah, thank you everyone for coming. And today we're going to be using some tried and tested tactics that have convinced insurers to stop Adani to stop them ensuring new coal mines. We're going to be hearing from speakers and taking action together. And yeah, going to be starting in a couple of minutes. Yeah, if you've just joined us, if you want to drop your name in the chat and say hi, where you're from, that'll be lovely. There's going to be chances for you to meet other people during this call as well. So we'll have some breakout rooms where you can discuss stuff so you won't just be listening. I'm sorry if you've already been on the call a little bit and this is getting repetitive, but there's new people joining, so I'm just going to go through again where we are. So yeah, thank you for joining the rally. And yeah, we're going to be starting soon. It'd be great if people could turn on their cameras. We'd love to see your faces. So we'll be, when we're not, when there's no one speaking, we've got it set up so you'll be able to see each other. Also, there is a, hopefully you've received emails. So if you're having trouble with technology, there is a phone number and an email address that you can ring to help you get on. If you're having a problem with your sound or something, I don't know if I could drop those details into the chat. And then if anyone's having any trouble, it's Daniel who you can get in contact with if you're having some problems with Zoom at the moment. And they will be able to help you. So yeah, welcome everybody. Oh, I can see my mum there. There we go. Hi, mum. yeah, if you've just arrived, drop your name in the chat and say hello and where you're from. And yeah, we are going to get going. I am now going to hand over to Flora from Some of Us, who's going to run through what's going to happen for the rest of the call. You'll hear from me again later.
Thank you, Andy. Hi, hello, everyone. Thank you so much for joining us today. I mean, this is true people power, so just appreciated that we had such a good quorum. So yeah, I'm Flora from Some of Us, and what we're doing here today is just basically make sure and pressure Lights of London to stop insuring coal and drop the Cumber coal mine and the Adani mine. Those are two horrific projects that doesn't make any sense according to science. I guess I don't need to preach any of this for you guys. So what we will be doing here today is that we're going to really take our voices to the leadership of On Lights of London. So we're going to do calendar jamming. So we're going to just clog their inboxes with calendar invites. We're going to do a call-in. So we're going to just make sure that they pay attention to us and pay attention to our demands. So just to give a little bit of introducing of this beautiful team that make this happen, so you have Andy that was just speaking. He's our MC together with myself. We have Rebecca overseeing everything, basically. we have Anne checking our chat. All of those guys are from Call Action. Then you have myself, Flora, and my colleague Olivia from Some of Us. And then we have Camila and Hausen managing our social media and Zoom. I guess it would be nice if you guys just gave a little wave so we know who's actually working on this in this rally. Another nice reminder that I would love to talk about is the Safer Space policy, which is just basic common sense contract we are all adhering here today, which is to respect each other and just to make this a welcoming space for everyone to share and to talk and make sure we, even in our differences, we are here to learn with each other and also, well, above all, just respect. And so the policy is being popped on the chat. It's a beautiful policy. I invited everyone to read. I think it's pretty cool. It just nice reminds of us humans. How can we be nicer and learn from each other every single time we interact, even if it's digital. We have a representative, which is Daniel. Daniel, I would love if you can just give a wave so everyone can see you. Cool, here's Daniel. Little shy. So if you have any problems, if you have any issues, if there's something that you're not, you know, feeling comfortable Just make sure to pop Daniel. Let's put in the chat his email. Just, you know, just write him a message, drop a line, and he will make sure to help you as much as we all can. Cool. I guess we're gonna get really started. Just a quick reminder, everyone, we can always see a gallery view, so you don't need to keep looking into whoever is speaking all the time, which can be, you know, too much. And you want to see who else is out there, you can always do a gallery view. So I'm just literally going to read the instructions. There is, you just go to gallery view, clicking the six dots on top of your right screen. Or you can also press Alt F2. In this way, you will be able to see everyone's faces, which is pretty cool as well, to see each other's reactions. Cool, we have enough quorum, which I think we can actually start and hand over to our first speaker. Just like Andy said, we're gonna listen from the forefront of people fighting Lloyd's of London underwriting projects. So we're gonna listen from the West Cumbria, activists, and also Stop It Dani project activists, and also Ensure Our Future as well. So this is why we're gonna start listening to their stories and the reasons why they're doing the beautiful work that they are doing. So I would love to start and introduce our first speaker, which is Lindsay Keenan. Lindsay, it would be lovely if you can just raise your hand so everyone sees you in the gallery. Cool. Great. Lindsay is a senior EU strategist for Ensure Our Future, and he will be talking a little bit about, you know, just introducing us Lloyd's of London, what they are and what they do and why it's so important that we are here today. So Lindsay, it's your floor.
Thank you, Flora. Can you hear me okay? Perfect. So brilliant to see so many people here. Fantastic. And Lloyd's of London. So some of us have heard of Lloyd's of London as a big insurance market, but perhaps few of us know exactly what it does. They insure everything, but I'm going to focus in on what's important for us, their insurance of fossil fuels. They are a marketplace with lots and lots of insurers in it. They have around 50 specialist insurers. They have around 200, a who's who of global insurance companies arranged in what they call syndicates, managed by a group of managing agents. They are the biggest insurance market in the world, and they insure in the Lloyd's market, approximately 40% of global energy sector insurance. So all of those coal mines, tar sands pipelines, new oil platforms, all of the dodgiest fossil fuel projects which are fueling climate change, 40% will be insured through the Lloyd's market. And in the surrounding areas to that Lloyd's market, there's another 15% in the wider London market, which is also connected to Lloyd's. So this is a globally important marketplace. And unfortunately, they sell themselves as a kind of insurer of last resort. We'll insure what others won't, and they really mean it. And unfortunately, that means coal mines, for example, where other insurance companies have been stepping away from them. Ensure Our Future campaign's been working for the last 3 years to try to get a who's who of global insurers to stop insuring coal and coal mines and to divest from them. And that's been quite successful, but Lloyd's is picking up the business that other people are more ethically dropping. So we're putting them under pressure. In December last year, under pressure from the campaigns which have been going on, Lloyd's produced its first environmental, social and governance policy. And in there, they also talked about coal. They're planning to bring a policy in January next year of not insuring any new coal mines. But they've also left themselves a big get-out clause. Anything which they're insuring up till now and through the rest of this year, they can continue insuring for at least the next 10 years. So that policy puts them well behind the rest of the European insurance industry and has them placed as the insurer of last resort. So we know They are ensuring the Adani Carmichael coal project, and they are the most likely potential insurer of the Cumbria coal mine. There is a briefing on our website. I'll post a link in a minute about Lloyds. It needs a little bit of an update since they introduced their ESG policy, but it gives you a lot of the background on this: managing agents, syndicates, how Lloyds is arranged. One thing I would say, Lloyds tries to make itself sound complicated so that people don't actually push it too hard to do things. Lloyds is actually quite simple. There's a Lloyds Council which has the authority to set policy across the entire market, to tell all of the members in the Lloyds market, you should not insure coal, for example. They have the legal authority to do that. In order to move Lloyds, what's been working so far is a combination, pushing the Lloyds management team and pushing the Lloyds members. And that's one of the things that we hope you guys are going to help with. Yeah, I won't talk too long. I could talk all day about Lloyds. They are globally important and they're crucial for the work on Adani. One of the few things stopping that Adani coal project going ahead just now is that it's fighting to get insurance. And they're one of the ways that we can stop the Cumbria mine. Thanks very much, and brilliant that you're all here. Really, really love it. Thank you.
Well, thank you for that, Lindsay. Yeah, like Lindsay says, there's a lot more detail that he could have got into on Lloyds, and there's a lot of information on the Insure Our Future website if you want to check that out and find out a bit more background stuff. But today we're going to be focusing more on some of the stories of the people who are battling these mines and then taking action together. So yeah, as many of you have heard, we've had some brilliant news this week on the Cumbrian mine. There's been called in for a public inquiry. But as many of you will know, that doesn't necessarily mean it's going to be stopped. We've also had some less well-known news this week and some community pressure that's already started to be put towards Lloyds to ask them to not insure the mine. There's been a couple of insurers that have said that they will not be insuring the West Cumbria mine, which is great. And hopefully today and the actions that we can take together going forward, we can increase that number to more and more. So yeah, and it shows that if government doesn't pull the plug on this mine, that we can stop it through this kind of action as well. So the next couple of speakers we've got are from Cumbria. They're gonna talk about the mine, why it shouldn't be going ahead, and some of their personal stories. First up is Isabella. She lives in Cockermouth in West Cumbria. She's been involved in youth strike movement in the region for the past couple of years. And she's also involved in the campaign to stop the mine locally, working with the community group Climate Emergency West Cumbria to organise actions such as writing objections and things like that. So we can't make any noise, so I'm going to ask people to give a big wavy hand sort of welcome to Isabella. So everybody wave your hands to say hello. And Isabella, over to you.
Hi, thank you. So I'm Isabella, I'm 16, and I live in Cockermouth in West Cumbria, about half an hour away from the proposed site of the coal mine. I started to get involved with the climate movement about 2 years ago, organising school strikes in the area. And through this, I became aware of the planned mine and the campaign against it. And I think I remember that the first thing I felt when I learned about the mine was this feeling of shock. It was 2019, Greta Thunberg was making global headlines. I felt like we were finally sort of shifting towards a greener society. And yet they're building this new coal mine on my doorstep. I remember my friend and I wrote to Robert Jenrick to see when he was considering calling in 2 years ago. And here we still are today, waiting to see what his decision will be on the mine. Is my audio okay?
Your audio is breaking up a little bit. I'm not sure what's going on. Do you want to just try without your camera on just to see if it makes a difference in case it's the bandwidth? Is that okay, Isabella? Just break you up a bit. Ah, technology. Are you still with us, Isabella? Oh. What I think we might have to do, it looks as if Isabella's connection has gone bad, is if Flora wanted to introduce the next speaker, that would be great. And I will, really keen to get Isabella back on, so we'll work to try and get her back on in a second. So
yes, let's do it. Thank you, Angie. Isabella will be back to, with us soon, I hope. So I would love to introduce Duncan Pollard. I'm very excited as well to hear him. To talk a little bit about Duncan, he resides in Cumbria. He's a member of SLAC, which is South Lakes Action on Climate Change Towards Transition. It's the local NGO leading the campaign against the coal mine. Duncan previously worked at WWF, leading many of the conservation programs that they have there. He did a brilliant job in sustainability at Nestlé as head of sustainability at Nestlé, and led their development of net zero climate policy. And also, for who else is interested, Duncan said that he's done a series of analyses on West Cumbria mining on Slack website. So I'm just gonna pop it into the chat for everyone who wants to have a look later on. But now the floor is to Duncan. Welcome.
Thank you very much for the introduction. Hello, everybody. Let me just say a few words. I'm a member of Slack. The Slack team that's campaigning against this coal mine has been led by Maggie Mason and a few others, including Henry and others. And they've been doing a fantastic job taking forward this threat of legal action, which has led to this news, this great news that we had last week. They've shown that the coal mine is not needed. I think we'll hear Isabella talk a little bit more about that, hopefully, if we get her back. The decisions that have been taken by the local council have really not followed the evidence, or they've not considered the right evidence. And that's all on the Slack website. It's made, of course, this mine very controversial, which is, I guess, why we're talking about it today. These climate arguments alone are very, very strong. This is a crazy project. What I wanted to do today was actually give you a few insights, a few different insights, which perhaps can be used in the campaign against Lloyds, using arguments that might resonate with Lloyds as well. And there are three main ones that I wanted just to talk about. They are the benefits that West Cumbria Mining talk about themselves, and that's the need for coal for steel, the fact that there will be a lot of jobs provided by this mine, and the fact that, or their proposal that they will pay a significant amount of taxes in the first 10 years, which will in turn bring all of these benefits. So let me just start with the first one of those, and that's really the demand for coal for steel. I do note that the Lloyds policy against coal is for thermal coal, which is the production of coal for energy. This is a mine which is going to produce coal for steel. But what's really interesting, I've been involved now for about a year in this mine project, and in that last 12 months there's been rapid advancement in by steel companies looking at alternatives to using coal, primarily hydrogen, but also increasing the amount of recycled coal. And it's likely that by the time that this mine would get to its full production, which would be about 2030, that there will actually start to be a declining market for coal. And therefore there's a real market risk, if you like, that Lloyds needs to know about. The second point is that West Cumbria Mining talk about creating 500 jobs. Their backers also talk about the fact that the shareholders talk about the fact that they invest in low-cost operations around the world. And in fact, whilst West Cumbria Mining mention the average salaries, the average wages that we'd be paying, it's not averages that matter in understanding this, it's median figures. And they're not publishing these median figures. My own calculations suggest in looking at this that the median will be below the current median for the region. And that is not enough to offer a decent living. In other words, these are not quality jobs that are going to be created. It's going to create a burden for the British taxpayer who will have to make up the difference to make up decent wages and standard of living for people. Indeed, there's been a report today by Cumbria Action for Sustainability. You can find it on their website that shows that there is an opportunity in that part of Cumbria alone for 4,500 jobs investing in renewable energy, if we were to focus on investing in renewable energy and energy efficiency. And so this is not a question about the politicians like to say that West Cumbria Mining is bringing jobs. There are even better opportunities for jobs in this part of the world. And finally, let me just mention the other benefit that they talk about, which is taxes. They're claiming that there would be £300 million worth of taxes paid in the first 10 years of the operation. I can't get to anywhere near these figures. If you look at the production volumes, you look at the production costs, the prices of coal, then quite frankly, if that's the taxes they're going to be paying, then mine is actually not economic. They're going to be paying all profits into taxes, which of course just won't happen. And that's even before considering the fact that West Cumbria Mining is owned by a company based in the Cayman Islands. You only open companies in the Cayman Islands in order to reduce taxes. One final thing that I will say, and it again is very specific, I think, to Lloyd's, and that's something called the Task Force on Climate-Related Financial Disclosure. Now, this is a voluntary initiative, actually, that's now supported by all major companies and all financial institutions. I say it's voluntary, but the British government is making reporting to the Task Force on Climate-Related Financial Disclosures mandatory within a few years. Now, Lloyd's, no surprise from the introduction that we heard, is actually a notable absentee from the list of supporters of TCFD, although it does claim its principles are in line with TCFD, but it's not made any disclosures along the lines required. Now, TCFD, the Task Force on Climate-Related Financial Disclosure, requires companies to report on the impacts of climate change on their operations. And then following from that, of course, what are they doing about it? How are they lowering those risks and lowering the emissions from the climate emissions? For Lloyd's, of course, that would mean them stopping doing business with high emitting companies like West Cumbria Mining. And so there is, of course, a certain irony that Lloyd's is insuring risks of natural disasters caused by climate change, whilst also insuring companies causing climate change. So, you know, from my perspective, what can you do? Well, ensure Lloyd's understands not only these reputational risks around insuring projects that are causing climate change, but the fact that there are severe questions around West Cumbria Mining in terms of the market for coal, for steel. There are questions around the quality of jobs that are going to be promised by this mine and the level of taxes and the profitability of West Cumbria Mining. In other words, they'd be better off not getting involved. Thank you.
Thank you, Duncan. And I will now hand over to Angie again so we can introduce Isabella.
Isabella, if you want to join in, do you want to just pick up where you were? The first bit of what you said was very broken up before, so maybe it's just best to start from the beginning again. Hopefully we work this a bit worse this time.
Yeah, is my audio better this time?
Perfect.
Okay. Perfect. So hi everyone. I'm Isabella, I'm 16, and I live in Cockermouth in West Cumbria, about half an hour away from the proposed site of the coal mine. And I started to get involved with the climate movement a couple of years ago through school striking, and through this became aware of the planned coal mine. And I think I remember like feeling this feeling of shock when I found out. It was 2019, Greta Thunberg was across the headlines. It felt like governments across the world were moving towards a slightly greener society, and yet there was this proposed coal mine on my doorstep. And I've lived in Cumbria for 6 years, so I'm fully aware that there is a need for jobs and investment in the area. I've seen the deprivation in the area and how the national government neglects the area, I know that like many of my friends can't wait to get out of the area and away to somewhere with better jobs. And so the 500 jobs allegedly provided by the mine are undoubtedly needed here, but they really shouldn't be coming at the expense of our environment and of our climate. As you're all aware, I'm sure, the UK government has committed to reaching carbon neutrality by 2050, but the coal mine is predicted to have a lifespan of over 50 years, which would take it well beyond this date. So there's a complete misalignment between this target of carbon neutrality by 2050 and the coal mine's existence. So therefore, is the best that can be offered to Cumbria, these jobs which are going to disappear again in 30 years? I feel like West Cumbria as an area deserves more than these unsustainable and unstable jobs. As Duncan mentioned as well, we're seeing improvements in technology, movements towards using recycled steel and other technologies. So there's going to be a significant reduction in the demand for coking coal over the next 50 years, during which the mine is supposed to be active. So again, these promised jobs are far from stable, secure, or sustainable. What West Cumbria really needs is investment in sustainable jobs, because local residents deserve better than these short-lived jobs in this polluting industry. And the proposed coal mine is forcing young people to choose between either a future without jobs or a future without a stable climate. And this division is deeply unfair and unjust. As Duncan briefly mentioned, we can see that there are ways of providing these jobs. The report that came out from Cumbria Action for Sustainability showed that 4,500 new jobs could be brought to the area over the next 15 years. And a recent report by Friends of the Earth also showed there were 1,500 opportunities to create green apprenticeships for young people in Cumbria over the next 3 years. This is what we should be investing in: jobs and apprenticeships which enable young people to find stable and sustainable employment, and which don't mean that we're going to face planetary collapse due to the emissions of a coal mine. And so, as we can see, because there are these ways of providing more sustainable employment, this ongoing battle that's been going on for so many years now makes me so angry and saddened to see, especially given the fact that I'm in school, I still can't vote, and yet the county council and the national government are making these decisions which will impact my future so much more than it will theirs. The lack of regard my local MP, Mark Jenkinson, and other politicians are giving to the environment deeply scares me. I completely understand where they're coming from in terms of the need for jobs in the area, but using this as an excuse to let climate polluting, climate damaging industries go ahead is completely unfair and unright and not right. And this proposal has been going for several years now. I remember writing to Robert Jenrick with my friend 2 years ago when he was again considering calling in the mine, and we're still here today waiting to see what his decision will be. We've lobbied the county council time and time again as they consider the decision. And Robert Jenrick's decision last week is a hugely positive step, and hopefully he sees sense and mind to go ahead. But I think it's vital that we use this moment to come together across the UK in order to mobilise against the mine. It's because this is a decision that will not only affect the jobs and residents in West Cumbria, but people across this, like across the nation and at an international level as well, due to the carbon emissions. With the UK having committed to the Paris Agreement, we now have a responsibility to follow this commitment by making decisions that are sustainable. And furthermore, we need to think of climate justice and how we can ensure that we are environmentally sustainable whilst providing the social justice of employment and investment into this deprived area. So what I really need as a young person with like not much influence due to the lack of a vote, due to the lack of power as a young person, is for people from across the UK to mobilise. And this is a great opportunity for us to do so together and to make the Lloyds Insurance Company pay attention to our demands and politicians in general pay attention to our demands. So I think for the first action of the rally, we wanted to get our voices heard on social media. So hopefully everyone here has brought a placard along. So I have my Nothing Neutral in New Coal sign. So it would be great if everyone could hold this up to the camera and someone's going to take a screenshot and get it shared across social media, I think. So hopefully we've got an image and that can be sent out across social media. So yeah, thank you all so much for turning up today, and hopefully we can get the Lloyds Insurance Company to pay attention to this. And I think we also wanted to try and lead a short chant just to get some like community spirit going. So one chant that we used, that I used when school striking, was no more coal, no more oil, keep our carbon in the soil. So if we can all unmute and try and chant this together for a couple of seconds, that would be great. So no more coal, no more oil, keep our carbon in the soil.
No more coal, no more oil.
No more coal,
no more oil,
no more oil,
no more oil,
keep our carbon in the soil.
No more coal, no more oil,
no more oil, no more coal, no more oil.
That was hilarious and great. It's like some weird round robin thing of many voices. Thank you, everybody. I'm gonna now go into our second online action. I'm going to hand over to Olivia.
Thank you, Andy, and thanks everyone. That was so fun. And it's just brilliant to see you all here this evening. I'm Olivia from Some of Us, and I'm going to talk everyone through our next action, which is the calendar jamming, which will hopefully be fun. Just a quick reminder that if you've been on SpeakerView and you want to see everyone's faces again, then you can switch back to gallery view just by pressing the six dots in the top right of the screen, or Shift and Alt and F2 on your keyboard. Okay, so as we heard already, two insurers have ruled out underwriting the West Cumbria coal mine, which is great, but obviously we need all of the rest of them to do it as well. And we want them to rule out, all coking coal, not just in Cumbria. And they've all been ignoring our emails and requests to clarify the position and rule it out, and generally avoiding the question. So it's obviously not good enough. So what we're going to do is send loads and loads and loads of calendar invites to the company directors and CEOs so that they have to pay attention to us. Each invitation we send will show up in their calendar and also send an email to their inbox. So when they open their email, they can have hundreds and hundreds of invites to these things, and it's going to be pretty hard for them to ignore it. I'm going to talk through quickly how to do this, but there's also a link in the chat to step-by-step instructions. So do take a look at that. Might be easier to follow on there. And importantly, all the emails of the people we are targeting are on there as well. Okay, so first you need to open up your Google Calendar. I'm assuming most people are using Google, but this is also possible on Outlook or Apple Calendar, whatever calendar you use. So once you're in your calendar, you click on the Create a Meeting button, and then you add a title of your liking, whether that's Don't Insure the West Cumbria Coal Mine or No More Coal or whatever takes your fancy. And then you click on Add Guests, and copy and paste in all the email addresses that are on that website that is shared in the chat with the instructions. If you scroll down a bit, you'll be able to see all the email addresses listed there. And then you basically just press save and do it all over again. Let's try and create as many events as we can and really fill up their calendars. Okay, so that's what we do. The step-by-step instructions are there in the chat. If you have any questions, post them in the chat. If you get stuck at all, do let us know. Someone can help you. And yeah, we'd love to hear your thoughts as you go. So feel free to post in the chat. So yeah, that's it. Good luck. Enjoy. Thank you. Oh, on the question about the date, you could, it's just up to you. You can pick different times during the week, try and set up lots of different events. The idea is just that they, when they look at their calendar, there will just be lots and lots of events all over the place. And they'll have to delete them individually. And so it will take up their attention. Thanks for the question, Sonia. Yeah, we're going to do that now. We're going to take a few minutes now before our next speaker. So, but also you can carry on doing it in your own time later on. So have a go now, but don't feel under time pressure if you want to do it in your own time as well.
In the instructions, if you've not got Google Calendar, there's also some details on how to set it up. If you feel like, I've not used this before and this seems a little bit too complicated for me, we have a letter and some email addresses that you could use as well if you want to do that instead during this time. So let me know. But the calendar is the best thing because they are kind of ignoring the emails already. So but I will put that in the chat. So if you want to. And the people who are watching the live stream, the hundreds of thousands of people watching the live stream right now, the link to this action is also in the text. So it's being put into the comments. So you'll be able to see that there and be able to do that as well.
Not sure about you, but I'm starting to receive quite a few emails declining the invite to have a meeting with them. So I hope you guys can start receiving those emails as well. So it's a true fact that they are seeing the invites.
That's great. And yeah, just to reiterate the point, if it's easier for anyone to do this later, then don't feel under pressure to do it now. And if you do it, feel free to tweet about it as well. Share your thoughts in the chat.
I had a message from someone who was using Outlook who just said, You need to remove the commas if you want it to work in that. So I apologize if people are using work. I don't know if anyone else has found that the case. Maybe pop it in there in the chat if you think you found that as well.
Okay, so if you're not being able to copy and paste the links in the chat, unfortunately, Zoom doesn't allow you to copy. So you have to click and then it's supposed to be open straight away. So if you're trying to copy, unfortunately, that's not possible. But yeah, just try to click and see if the link works for you.
I was also really regretting that we didn't have any music lined up for this section. So I apologize for our lack of planning and not having some great tunes for while we all do that.
Okay, brilliant. Well, I hope people didn't find that too confusing. And thank you so much to everyone who tried and managed to send emails. I think we're going to move on to the next stage now. So I'm going to hand back to Andy, who's going to talk through the breakout rooms, which is the next stage. Thanks, everyone. Bye.
Well, I'm sorry if that was a bit chaotic for me. Some got through and some didn't. So I think like maybe us all doing it at the same time was really getting to them. I don't know. But yeah, the next stage of what we're going to do is like the breakout sessions. So we all know that sending some calendar invites on its own isn't going to create the transformative changes we need to avoid the climate breakdown. And what the experience from people in Australia who've been doing the similar strategy to get lawyers to pull out of theirs, we need people all over the UK to be joining this campaign to actually win this. Luckily, all you lovely folks have turned up this evening. So there's a good start of a good number of people who want to get involved. So in this next section, we're going to give you a chance to meet some of the other people who are here tonight, have a little bit of chat, introduce yourselves, and also just share some ideas of the kind of actions that we could be taking together in 2021 to really highlight this issue to Lloyds. It might be ideas that you've seen from other campaigns or actions that you've done yourself against other targets. Could be digital things, other ideas for things we could be doing digitally, or ideas as we come out of the lockdown restrictions. Fingers crossed. If there isn't a third or fourth or fifth wave, the things that we could start to do on the streets. I'm sure some of you are thinking, well, I don't live in London. Lloyds of London's obviously in London, but luckily they have regional offices all over the UK. So there are chances for people to be doing stuff locally as we come out of lockdown. But I think like also online tactics, we're going to hear from Lisa from Stop Adani about what they've been doing soon, but have a little think about other things you could be doing, things that you think have worked with you before. So we're going to split you into breakout sessions in a second. This is going to, you're going to have 10 minutes roughly to in this to chat. We're not going to be facilitating these. There'll be about like five people maybe in your breakout room. So we're not going to be facilitating it. So just introduce yourselves when you get in. And when we come back, if people can try and keep track of ideas that they've come up with, maybe if someone in the group wants to take notes, then we'll post those in the chat when we come back so everyone can see the great ideas that everyone's come up with. If you're struggling in any way, and you need some help in your group, there is a ask for help kind of button while you're inside the breakout rooms, and somebody will be able to come in. And just remember, we're all here together, so treat everybody with respect and try and give everybody a chance to speak inside your breakout room. And remember, no ideas are stupid ideas. So there we go. We're going to go over to it now.
If you haven't joined a breakout room yet, if you click on the join button once the window pops up, you will be put into a breakout room with about four or five other participants where you can have a discussion about tactics and what actions you can take going ahead. Hi, Penny. That can happen sometimes when the Wi-Fi doesn't handle Zoom too well. Is there another pop-up? Can you try and join again, or is it not showing you the invite anymore? Let me just...
Okay, can you hear me now?
Yeah. Is there an invite for you to join a breakout room or?
The
He's asked for the password.
The password to join a breakout room?
Well, he's asked for the meeting number, so we went back to the email and clicked on it to join again.
Right.
So here we are, and there's someone called Penny that hasn't joined the room 12.
So what we thought we could do instead while waiting for other people to come back in is to have a chat ourselves here instead of joining breakout rooms. And you should be all able to unmute yourselves as well.
We've unmuted.
Yeah, great. So we could just chat about what tactics we could use to target Lloyd's insurers.
Well, in recent weeks, we have been doing calendar jamming and emails organised by the Stop Adani group in Australia. So we've had to get up early in the morning because of time of their meetings to do it. It's sort of 8 o'clock in the morning our time. But they gave us specific Lloyd's insurers to target and specific director names. But the list we went to sort of 3-4 minutes ago that you provided, we seemed to have a list of about 100 names and we couldn't kind of pick on something.
Yeah, so, I mean, that list was meant if you copied and pasted literally all email addresses, then you could send the invite to everyone at the same time. And that's...
It was a list of... Mixed up.
Wait a minute till she's finished.
It was a list of loads of email addresses, and that was of the insurers that haven't ruled out insuring the Cumbria coal mine, the West Cumbria coal mine. So it's kind of different from the Stop Adani campaign in that many more insurers within the Lloyd's marketplace haven't ruled out insuring the West Cumbria coal mine, and hence we thought of sending calendar invites to loads more people and to try and target loads more people. And all those people had positions such as CEOs or directors of those insurance companies. The reason why we put them all there in a chunk with commas was so that that calendar invites could be sent to all of them in one go. And so loads more could be created quicker, basically. Maybe we should move on.
They are not. So
other people can participate in the call.
That we can use. They're not in a form that we can use because they're mixed up with names. It's not a list of email addresses.
Where did you get that list?
I think I can send you the link to the action again. But in the meantime, maybe we can start chatting about other things that we can do to target those insurers, kind of moving beyond calendar jamming. Other things that we could do either online or in person once lockdown restrictions. So I don't know if anyone else has any ideas. Yeah, say there's like one of the insurers' office somewhere near close to where you live. What do you think you could do to target them and demand that they rule out insuring the West Cumbria coal mine? Does anyone have any ideas about that?
Just to jump in there, I think that we are actually being live streamed at the moment. So for this group, it might not be ideal to sort of talk about specific actions and things because you never know who might be watching. whereas people in the other breakout groups, those aren't being live streamed. So they can do their plotting without fearing that anyone else is looking in.
Hi everyone, I'll just give it a second for everyone to get back in. That was nice to meet three of you anyway, while we're in the breakout room. I hope that was interesting to chat to some other people. I'm sorry that there isn't more time as well for you to sort of get to know people and have a bit more to chat about ideas. We're just going to cover quite a lot of content in an hour and a half, so couldn't spend too long on that. But yeah, it'd be great if people wanted to put any of their top ideas in the chat for things that they thought we could be doing on Lloyd's. So yeah, if people could post in there, that would be great. So also we'll record the chat as well at the end of the at the end of the thing, so we'll be able to see what ideas people have come up with, and we can suggest those to other people. So it's a bit of a brainstorming, and hopefully, even if we don't end up doing these ourselves, other people might do. So yeah. And yeah, I just wanted to say, if people were interested in carrying on those conversations, there's my email address is in there. I'm really keen to find people who want to do stuff like on an ongoing basis around Lloyds and around the West Cumbria mine going forward. And it doesn't matter where you live in the country, but yeah, please give me an email. It'd be great to sort of carry on these conversations. We can link people up with other people in their region if they're not already part of an existing group, so that we can take some of these actions going forward. So yeah, that's my email, andrew@coalaction.org.uk. So yeah, cool. Well, thank you for that, everybody. I'm now gonna hand over to Lisa. So Lisa is joining us all the way from Australia. It's very early in the morning over there, so thank you for getting up so early to join us. I know it's not great in the time zone. Lisa's from Coffs Harbour, where she's been organising with her local Stop Adani group to try and stop the Adani mine for many years now. She is super dedicated, and I have been lucky enough to meet her when I was in Australia. In fact, when I saw her last, she was going off to sleep under a stage for an evening so that she could pop out and disrupt a pro-coal politician's speech in the morning. So I will now hand over to her. If everyone wanted to give a big wave to welcome Lisa as well, that would be lovely.
Hi, everyone. Thanks for the intro, Andy. I wasn't expecting that. Sorry about the stage. So as Andrew said, my name's Lisa. I'm speaking to you from the east coast of Australia. It's 5 o'clock in the morning here, so I'm a little sleepy, but it's really exciting to be speaking with you all over the way on the other side of the world. It's really great to be part of a global movement. I've been a climate campaigner for the last 8 years. The last five of those have been focused mainly on the Stop Adani campaign. Here in Australia, we are the world's biggest exporter of coal. The coal we ship out to the world is our major contribution to the climate crisis. So I feel like it's our responsibility here to keep as much of that coal in the ground as possible. Adani's proposed Carmichael coal mine has become one of the world's most powerful and toxic symbols on the planet for the expansion of the coal industry. And the Stop Adani movement has grown into the biggest climate campaign our country has ever seen. So I don't know how much you all know about Adani, so I'll give you a bit of background. Adani is an Indian mining billionaire who is trying to build the biggest coal mine in Australia's history in Queensland. The mine site is on the ancestral lands of the Wangan and Jagalingu people. They have never given their consent for the mine, and they've fought hard to stop it, exhausting all the legal avenues. The mine would destroy their cultural lands, and it would also pose a huge risk to precious water resources, something which is even more valuable as our country faces more extreme droughts with climate change. Coal from the mine would be shipped out through the Great Barrier Reef, with 500 coal ships passing through the Reef World Heritage Area every year for 60 years. And of course, there's the actual coal. When burnt, that coal would add 4.6 billion tonnes of carbon pollution to our atmosphere. And if that's not bad enough, if allowed to go ahead, Adani's mine would pave the way for at least 8 more coal mines to be built in the Galilee Basin, one which is currently one of the world's largest untouched coal reserves. So by stopping Adani, we're stopping all of these mines, and it's really critical that we do. Adani initially planned to be shipping coal out by 2014, but our movement has delayed it for over 7 years. They still haven't dug out a single lump of coal. And while they're now saying they plan to ship out coal within the year, construction has been incredibly slow, risky, and expensive. Adani does unfortunately now have its major legal approvals to start building the mine, but we've had solid success in our corporate campaigns with dozens of major contractors refusing to work on the mine and major banks refusing to finance it. So one of the key pieces of the puzzle that Adani still needs is insurance. Already 25 major global insurers have publicly ruled out insuring it. So we've narrowed it down to Lloyd's Insurance Marketplace. Stopping Adani getting insurance through Lloyd's is our current movement focus. You've already heard a bit about Lloyd's this morning, I think. So you may know that they've recently made a commitment to no new insurance policies for coal mines from January 2022, which is a really, really significant step. However, they can still extend existing insurance for coal mines, or renew insurance for coal mines out to 2030. So our mission is to make sure no Lloyd's insurer is willing to touch Adani's coal project, and to make sure anytime an insurance deal comes up for renewal, not a single Lloyd's insurer is willing to renew them or take the place of others. And we've already had some significant wins on this. To sum up, I've got a bit of the numbers. There are 90 Lloyd's insurers in total. 32 of them could have provided some sort of insurance for Adani's coal mine. As of this week, I think 22 of those insurers have ruled out Adani, which leaves 10 who have yet to rule it out, but only 4 who are big enough to facilitate insurance for Adani. So our focus is now on those 4 key insurers, who are ARC, Arch, Markel, and Hamilton. Last year when we had so many insurers to target, our approach here was to divide them up between local Stop Adani groups across Australia. My local group here in Coffs Harbour, we adopted Brit. They were one of the biggest, and it turns out they were actually involved in insuring the rail part of Adani's coal project. Just a couple of weeks ago, they announced that they would not insure the mine or renew insurance for the rail, which was a really massive win, really exciting and uplifting for us, and shows that our tactics are effective. So now that we're down to the last 4 Lloyd's syndicates, we're able to combine our powers. So while we think the remaining 4 may be the most resistant to move, we've already pushed so many off this project. So we think we can push 4 more to do the right thing and distance themselves from Adani. With no big insurance companies to lead on the deals, Lloyd's may no longer be an option for Adani. And without Lloyd's, Adani may have next to no options for where they go for insurance. So yeah, with the project already on a knife edge, it's facing a heap of challenges, including flooding on site. A lack of access to insurance would be a major, hopefully fatal blow to the project. So what do we know about what works on pushing insurers? I think the biggest key is persistence. Persistent pressure on the board, management and staff has had an impact. Our group here spent several months calling, emailing, calendar jamming Brit without any clear response. A lot of the time we didn't know if anyone was reading our emails or listening to our phone messages. So it was really gratifying to see that that pressure did add up to push them out. It's also important to keep learning, reflecting and adapting. When they started blocking emails, we used different words and used creative spelling with keywords like Adani. We got into calendar jamming. We tried different times to call. We tried other avenues like LinkedIn and social media. It's fun to kind of see it as a bit of a game, to get innovative and to just be everywhere that we can be. Clearly before, previously we used to do a lot of in-person actions, but even without doing those in-person actions, we've been able to be very effective and even from a distance for us from the other side of the world. Another thing to remember is that the staff are potential allies. Many of the staff for these insurance companies do care about the future habitability of the planet, just like we do. It affects all of us. So we think of them as potential allies. We're polite and respectful. We know that many staff raising their voices on the inside has aided our wins so far. But having said that, we do aim to be disruptive. It's the build-up of calls and other interventions over time which has pushed them to make a public statement. So I think we're all going to make a phone call now to insurer ARC. I believe there's a guide which will be shared in the chat with an example script and other tips with the phone numbers. So I'm going to do an example call for you. I think I'm going to be calling the CEO of ARC, whose name is Ian. And then we'll have a break where we all can make a call. So when you call, you're going to let them know where you're calling from, let them know you're concerned about Adani's coal mine in Australia. Most likely we'll be leaving voicemails, I think, because of the timing. But if you do get through to someone, have a chat, let them ask them if they've heard about Adani's coal mine. You can let them know that many Lloyd's insurers have ruled out insuring Adani and that we're asking for a commitment to them to do the same. Okay, so I'm gonna, hopefully this will work.
Hello, this is Ian. Please leave a message.
Begin speaking after the tone. Then hang up when you are finished or press any key for further options.
Hi, Ian. My name's Lisa. I'm calling from Coffs Harbour, Australia. I have some questions about ARC's involvement with Adani's Carmichael project here in Australia. We're really concerned about this coal mine because it would fuel dangerous climate change. It's on the lands of the Wanganjagalingu people. It's a threat to groundwater here and the Great Barrier Reef. We know that lots of Lloyd's insurers have ruled out working with Adani, but we are calling on ARC to join them. We're calling on ARC to provide a written statement along the lines of ARC will not provide insurance for Adani's Carmichael coal mine, rail or port. And I would appreciate if you could raise this internally. Thank you. Okay, so that's pretty much it. I think there's a few different numbers you can try, but hopefully we can fill up their mailboxes, their voice message boxes. And I think if anyone would prefer not to make a call now, there's an option to do a LinkedIn action instead. I think you should just put that in the, yeah, that's in the chat. If you would prefer to join that, there's a breakout group to do that now. And you can write in the chat with how you go with your calls. If you get through to somebody, absolutely let us know. I think you can tweet about it as well. So I'll leave you to it. Thanks very much for having me. It's a pleasure. And thanks for being involved. Go make those calls.
Thank you, Lisa.
For whoever is interested in doing the LinkedIn action, you can just check the document in our chat. I'm gonna ask, Camila is putting some instructions there as well. And we're gonna put some music on where we make some fun phone calls and make some nice voice messages.
Yeah. que se va para los cielos, ese querido angelito, a rogar por sus abuelos, por sus padres y hermanitos. Cuando se muere la carne, el alma busca su sitio, adentro de una amapola o dentro de un pajarito. La tierra lo está esperando, con su corazón abierto, por eso es que el angelito parece que está despierto. Cuando se muere la carne, le limpia su carita en la mañana. Cuando se muere la carne, el alma busca su diana en los misterios del mundo que le ha abierto su ventana.
Okay, everyone, I hope that was fun. I wish we could stay all night just trying to call them in, but I think we are clocking their their phones. So the list is there, the fun things that we can do this at any time. So if you have like a longer lunch break, you can just try to give them a call and ask for explanations. It would be nice, you can always report back to us as well. I think it would be nice to post in the chat the Andy's email. So anything you guys want to report back from any of these actions that we took today, that will be fun to know what response they gave you. So I think we're about to wrap up our event. So it's been a fun an hour and a half with all of you. I guess we just really want to appreciate, deeply appreciate the presence of everyone who took some time of their evenings. We could be all just watching some TV or eating a supper, but we decided to show up, and that's really powerful. I see some people still leaving messages, which is really cool. I guess we are always looking into grow this campaign. So every single action that we take, it's important. Don't stop now, as I know we won't, but you know, if you want to keep growing the campaign and you have ideas and you want to get further engaged, make sure to drop an email to andrew@coaction.org.uk. It's already on the chat. I think we can always post it. There will be soon a website on Lloyd's of London. It should be ready by, I think, mid next month, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, it would be soon, and you guys will definitely know about it when the exact date of this website it's ready, where we're gonna just, you know, compile all the informations about Lloyd's of London. Someofus.org.uk also has some interesting, also has some interesting features. For any of you who wants to create your own petition, you can go to the website. It'd be really cool if someone can post it on the chat as well. It's a community website where every single one of us can just create a petition. So you can do it locally, you know, you can do your own action the way you see fit, and that's pretty cool. We have different languages as well, so you can share it with your friends if you want to take an action on any projects around the road, and whatever topic you want to engage on. And I just really want to thank everyone for coming, for the attendance, and also for our speakers. It's really always inspiring and important for us to hear of those at the forefront. And yeah, I guess this is a wrap. I would love, just before we go, if we hold our signs just one more time, so we can try to get one more picture. And yeah, let's get ready to make this work. So if everyone just really just hold next to your face, so we make sure that it's see you. Yeah, it's just really, really visible. Cool. I guess let me just do like 10 seconds, like 2 seconds, 1 second. I think we've got time to get the screenshot. I hope so too. Okay, guys, I guess this is it. Much love to you all, and let's keep on fighting. They're listening to us.